Hello everyone, Amy R here with Prairie Paper and Ink, and for today's cards I'm going full on ugly Christmas sweater theme. So I used Simon Says Stamp's Christmas Sweater background stamp, and it is a red rubber stamp on cling foam. So I put it on the lid of my Misti, and then I removed the foam insert in my Misti so I could stamp with it. And I don't remember who showed me this the first time. I've shown this in other videos though. Is I ink up the stamp. This time I'm using Simon Says clear embossing ink, and I'd already used my anti-static powder tool on the cardstock. And then I lay the cardstock on top of my stamp, which I've shown in many videos, but with using it with the Misti is you just flip the Misti closed kind of upside down so that the cardstock stays in place. And then I can flip it back over, press the lid down really, really well to make sure I get a really even impression with my background stamp. Really like using it this way when I think of doing it. So I did it, ended up doing this twice on the Bristol Smooth cardstock, and I'm using Nuvo's clear embossing powder. So you can't really see much on camera since it's clear on white cardstock. But I did two pieces of that with this Christmas sweater background that I just immediately thought of doing like ugly sweater themed cards, since that's such a big trend, especially this year. I've been seeing them everywhere. So after I coated everything with the clear embossing powder, I'm melting it with my heat tool. And then I did it a second time so that I had two pieces. And I put both pieces onto my just grid paper from Simon Says Stamp, just to kind of keep the ink a little bit more contained, because I plan on doing a ton of ink blending. This actually didn't take very long. I did super speed up this part, but it honestly didn't take long at all. And I'm just using some post-it tape, and I'm just kind of masking off each section of this background since it's kind of in stripes. And then for each section, I'm using a different color of Simon's ink and doing it all in different shades of reds and greens and trying to make this as gaudy as possible, really. You could do this and keep things a little more simple. You can definitely go more elegant. Like, there's so many options with a background stamp like this, but I definitely wanted it to be really colorful and kind of crazy. And still obviously very Christmas themed. I was thinking though, when I was pulling out my inks, I was like, ooh, this would look really pretty done in like, you know, blues and purples. And you could do just a winter themed card with this, or, you know, anything like that, like just cozy themed. But I was wanting to go full on Christmas. So every time I switched or moved the post-it tape, I would switch it around so that I kept the reds on one side and the greens on the other, just in case the inks would... didn't want them to, like, you know, pick up the different color from the blending tool. And even though with these inks I usually don't have much trouble with that, and these inks do sponge beautifully, I didn't do a perfect blend with any of them. I kind of wanted it to be a little messy, just because, one, time constraints, and two, I just really wasn't too worried about the backgrounds, because the inks do smooth out a bit as they dry, and it kind of just adds to it if they're not perfectly even anyway. So altogether, I ended up using 7 different shades of ink. You could keep it simpler and just use, you know, a couple different shades and just kind of alternate them, you know, red, green, that would totally work too. But since I have all the inks, I thought I might as well use them. So after I was done all that sponging, I used the largest Simon Says stitched rectangles die, as well as one of the stitched circle dies. And I just used some post-it tape to kind of hold the dies together in the place so that I could run this through with the one piece and then quickly remove it and run it through with the second piece. So I've got both die cuts here. And I also die cut some of Simon's new green glitter cardstock with that same circle die. And technically, those cutouts with the patterns on them, those I could totally use those to make one or if not two more cards, but didn't have time. But I set them aside because it's like, oh, hopefully I'll get to it later and be able to make some more cards with it. So after I did all that, I die cut some green cardstock with the tree dies from the Simon Says Stamp CZ Design Coolest U-List die set that coordinates with the stamp set. And normally I stamp and then die cut after, but I knew I wanted to stamp all these with pigment ink, and I didn't want to waste time to dry the pigment ink afterwards and then before running it through my machine, because I find if you stamp with pigment ink and then run it through your die cut machine too soon, like before it's fully dry, the ink will transfer to the die cutting plates, and then I'll go to die cut something down the road and then I get ink on it. It's happened. So now I just, if I'm planning on stamping with pigment inks, I usually will do my die cutting first if I can, or I'll take the time to heat set it, which today I didn't do. So I stamped the tree images from the same stamp set onto their die cuts. And then for the reindeer, I had die cut the red card. So this is Schoolhouse Red from Simon. So I die cut that, and then I'm stamping the reindeer. And this is Hero Arts Unicorn White Pigment Ink. And then I pulled out this Ranger Snowflake Tinsel embossing powder. And it's basically kind of a off-white embossing powder with chunky holographic glitter in it. I showed this in a haul video some time ago. It's really fun. It's just kind of different. You're not going to get a perfectly smooth embossed image with this. Maybe if you applied two coats if you wanted. I was okay with that though. I didn't want it to be perfect. I just wanted, you know, the glitter and the fun look of it, because ugly sweater theme, this is perfect. So I would just ink up the stamp, stamped onto its die cut. I was holding it with the reverse tweezers because there's very little like leeway around the perimeter of this die cut. And then I was coating it with that snowflake tinsel embossing powder and then heating it up. And you can heat it up from underneath. I'll show that again with the sentiments I do for the inside of the card. When you're working with any sort of embossing powder that's very like has glitter content or is just a more chunky embossing powder, it helps usually to heat up from behind the image on the other side of the cardstock. That'll melt it without the force of the air from the heat tool blowing off all that glitter. So that's what I did with these. So I got them all completely melted, and then I'm gonna funnel that embossing powder back into its container and put the lid on so that I don't knock it over everywhere. And then I had die cut some white cardstock with one of the Ho dies from the CZ Design Hose die set. There's a large one and a smaller one. So I ended up die cutting six altogether, and I'm going to stack three of them for each card with my multi-medium matte adhesive, just applying a really thin line of that and then stacking those die cuts just to give it a little extra something. So I'm going to get that all stacked up, and I'm going to do that twice so that I've got two of these die cuts. And then to attach the glitter kind of inlay circle, I just flip these over, and I'm just using a bit of scotch tape to adhere those into place. And then I'm going to coat the backing of these with Simon's Big Mama foam tape roll. A lot of people asking me what my thoughts are on this. I honestly don't mind it. I know a lot of people are saying they don't care for it. They have trouble with removing the backing. I honestly only had trouble today because I trimmed down my nails. The times I used it like the day before and like right after I got it, I didn't have as much trouble getting it because my nails were a lot longer. But I don't have too much trouble. I do find though this works better if you cut it rather than trying to rip it. It doesn't tear the easiest, but I'm really liking it because it's so much thinner than my 3M tape. I'm still going to use my 3M foam tape for a lot of projects, but I'm liking just having this option of something thinner but gives it that little bit of dimension. So I'm coating the backs of these with that foam tape, peeled off the backing, and then I'm popping these onto my card bases, which are heavyweight white cardstock. So these are all top folding A2 sized cards. So once I've got these popped onto their bases, I can start assembling my little like card fronts here. So I'm going to adhere the trees flat to the card with my multimedia matte adhesive, especially since I'm adhering over the glitter cardstock. This makes sure like these are going to adhere really, really well to that. And then for the reindeer, I decided to use my little Derice foam strips because they're so thin and I wanted these popped up just a little bit just for something fun. So I just trimmed down little pieces of these foam strips and stuck them on the back of the deer, and then would pop that into place. And then for the sentiment, I'm using the multimedia matte again, just applying a thin coat of that to the back of it. And then once I have that in place, I put an acrylic block down over it to hold it in place while it dries, just to make sure that it adheres really well to the glitter paper and to the background. So once I've got that completely adhered, I went on, did the second card, and then I had to add some embellishments. And I actually went a little conservative. I was going to go all out with the embellishments because once you start going like ugly sweater themed, you know, Christmas sweater themed, it's like you can go just nuts and add whatever you want because that's half the fun. I was thinking afterwards how fun this would have been to add some little like chibi lights and make these like light up in areas. That would have been so much fun. But hindsight, hindsight. I'll have to do some more maybe for next year's Christmas card series or something, because you can just really go all out with this. I ended up using some Studio Cadia snow crystals and some red heart crystals, and just kind of sprinkle those rather liberally on my card fronts, and I'm adhering them all into place with more of that multi-medium matte adhesive, just putting little dabs of that down and then pressing those into place. So the red heart crystals have like a nice kind of iridescent shimmer to them. And then the snow crystals, they are faceted so that you get like a reflection on them as well. They're something that you kind of need to see in real life, because on camera and everything, they just look flat, if that makes any sense. So set those aside. Now I want to do the inside of the card. And rather than stamp this large merry sentiment, I decided to stamp it onto some more of this red cardstock with that white pigment ink and coat them again with this snowflake tinsel embossing powder, just to kind of tie everything together. And because these sentiments, this merry word is so thick, it works really well with this embossing powder. So then again, stamp both of them, and then I'm melting them from behind with the embossing tool, heat tool, so that it's not blowing off all that glitter and everything's melting really nicely. Once it's all melted and has a second to cool off, I can use the coordinating die that comes in the Coolest U-List die set to die cut both of these. So I'm going to run these through my machine and die cut them. And another reason I chose to do it this way is when I go to stamp the Christmas sentiment on the inside of the card, I was like, oh, if I mess this up and don't stamp it straight, I can adhere the Merry over top of it and you won't even know. So I just kind of lined everything up and then inked up the Christmas with one of the same green inks I used on the front of the card, and then adhered the Merry into place with the multimedia matte adhesive. And I'm going to do that to the second card, and that finishes these off. So I'm getting really close to finishing my Christmas card series for this year. This is number 21 of hopefully 25. I feel like I am like racing the clock, but I'm having so much fun doing these. I hope you guys are enjoying these videos. As always, there will be a link below the video to my blog post with links to all the supplies used. So you can check out that info in the description box below the video. Thank you all so much for watching and subscribing and thumbs upping and commenting on my videos. I really appreciate the support, and I will see you all very soon in the next one. Bye.